Were you pretty scared?
Well, basically, you know, I was real scared. You know, how would you feel if you was laying somewhere and you couldn't move?
Stanley Doughty remembers twice getting hit very hard while playing for the University of South Carolina.
I can hear voices, but I couldn't actually move.
When it happened the first time, it was 2004. Doughty says the university took him to a specialist in Charlotte who told him not to worry about his injury. A year later came another violent hit during a game. He was taken to the locker room and told to get back on the field.
You got to be tough. You're a football player.
Couldn't feel your legs.
Correct.
And all they did was take you into the locker room and tell you you had to be tough?
Correct.
They didn't say you need to see a doctor, even though this had happened before. You said my neck's hurting, and they just said, go out there and play.
Right. We need you, Stanley. The team needs you to be supportive.
The team's injury report for Doughty shows he did have a nerve injury at the cervical spine. The school's response was that Doughty had suffered what in football is called a stinger, or temporary numbness, and it's common practice to send a player back into the game after symptoms subside. The team cleared Doughty. He continued playing the rest of the season. Growing up poor in tiny Amite, Louisiana, Doughty lived and breathed football. He was a local star.
Two All-Star games, MVP, All-Star, and I made Player of the Year in Louisiana. I had about 35 offers.
In his third year at South Carolina, even before finishing his degree, he was signed by the Kansas City Chiefs, a lifelong dream to go pro finally realized. But after his first medical exam, according to his lawsuit, the Chiefs head trainer said Doughty was too injured to play.
Basically, they told me I could be paralyzed from the neck down.
So the Chiefs are telling you, the Chiefs doctors are saying this is a really big deal, and South Carolina says no, it's not.
South Carolina said it don't exist.
South Carolina disputes that Doughty's injuries were serious. They say he didn't seek further medical treatment and that the university provided appropriate and extensive medical care, including treatment by team athletic trainers, physicians, and out-of-state specialists.
When I hold my head back, I feel tingling down my traps, like coming down my shoulders.
Doughty says he's unable to work, and he's finding it hard to cope. He thought he'd find justice in the class action lawsuit that just reached a preliminary settlement, $75 million. But the money is going to screening and research. Doughty won't get a dime. The lawyers will get paid, and other players in the class action can file individual lawsuits. But Doughty's case falls outside the statute of limitations. So with no college degree, no financial payment, and needing surgery, Doughty now feels betrayed by so many.
But I go through pain every day, but I try not to think about it. I just try to keep pushing. So that's the life of Stanley Doughty.